In metrology, there's a thing called nominal actual comparison, and it's a report that is used for quality control by comparing two different 3D models of the same part. Here is an example of what such a report looks like. It's actually quite colorful, almost like a painting. I'll give you two examples where such a report is needed. Hi, my name is Swan with Holocreators, and now let's give you the first example. Imagine a company is producing metal gears, and every day this company makes about 1,000 gears. And out of their production line of 1,000 gears, they take 6 gears and they 3D scan them. And now from the time when the company originally designed the very first gear, they still have a CAD file. That's like a blueprint, a 3D model with all the perfect dimensions and all the measurements. And what we can do is we can compare this CAD file to the 3D scans. And this is called, well, a nominal actual comparison. And it will help to visualize and to measure how much the gears from the production line deviate from the perfect gear. So with this report, the engineers can go to the production line and adjust the machinery so the production is improved. So that would be one case where a nominal actual comparison report could be useful. My second example is quality control of a reverse engineering. And this is daily business here for my company, because we make a 3D scan and then we make a reverse engineering of that scan. And when we make the reverse engineering, we can only make an approximation of the 3D scan. So no matter how hard we try, there will always be some deviation of the reverse engineering to the original scan. Now our customers want to know how much this deviation is. So we create a nominal actual comparison report, and there we will visualize and they can see all the measurements and deviations down to the 10th or 100th of a millimeter. So there are a few steps to creating such a report. And the first step is to import the nominal data. So if you remember my first example, that would be the CAD file of the perfect gear. And then in the second step, we import the actual data. So that would be the 3D scans from the metal gears from the production line. And then in the third step, both of these data sets are aligned in 3D space, so they overlay each other. And in the fourth step, we create the actual report by making the overlay and then looking how much the deviation is between the two. This is what a nominal actual comparison report looks like. So on the left side, we have the 3D scan of the metal gears. So this is the 3D scan. This is the actual data. And then on the right side, we have the nominal data. So that would be the perfect CAD file of the metal gear. And now we overlay both surfaces. So now we overlay both surfaces and we get this diagram here. On the right side, you can see the, make this a little smaller. On the right side, you can see the legend. In the center, it's green. Any material that lies above the nominal data is indicated in red. And any material that lies below the nominal data is indicated as blue. So they line up pretty well. But like in here in this area, you can see that the material from the 3D scans is below the nominal data. And in the red areas, it's above. So we have some error areas here. And then we have also these markers where you can specify the deviation in certain areas. So here would be, the deviation would be 0.39 millimeters. Above the nominal data, and in this area it's minus 0.07 millimeters below the nominal data. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like, you can subscribe to the channel, and see you next time when I talk about some other fascinating topic. See you around. Bye bye.